Warren. I'm here actually to try and show you how to do something because I have no idea what I'm doing. And I figure if I can do it, you sure as hell can as well. The reason I'm down in the basement here, I don't know if you can kind of see, but it's nasty and nice and grindy, grummy down here, is because this morning we woke up and we did not have any hot water. So that was going to be interesting. Showers are fun. And, you know, 50-degree temperature. Yeah. So, I come down here trying to figure out what's going on. I look at a few YouTube videos and things like that, and all the know-how people tell you that, hey, you can fix this yourself. So, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to fix this myself. We'll see if we can piece all this together here and get ourselves some answers. What I've done is I've gotten in here. We're taking a few things apart. First thing, obviously, we took off this this door, which is basically just a cover. That's all it is. It just sits in there to keep things apart. And then undid the bolts on this panel here and removed the whole burner assembly. Obviously, needed a small. We used a wrench, a simple adjustable wrench, so that we weren't messing anything up. It's got some nice soft teeth. Doesn't have any of the actual hard teeth on there because I didn't want to damage any of these copper fittings. So what I did was I undid them from here underneath. You've got your different assemblies. First valve, the second one was here in the middle. Goes all the way up into there. And then you got number three there. So these guys are out. This is the whole burner assembly now. And what I did was I did purchase a replacement for the thermocouple and got to looking at the part here. And on here, I'll just show you here. This is a state water heater. And on the state water heater, the thermocouple is special. It has this resistor in the middle here and comes back up. And so basically, and just kind of go over here, we've got our actual pilot, this thing here with the hole in the side. I get this to adjust, unfortunately. We've got a pilot, and then right here, this white part with the thing sticking up, that's it. That's the actual electric starter. And then over here is the thermocouple. This is what registers the temperature of the pilot to tell the system whether or not the gas should be on or off, because the pilot's either working or not working. So it's a safety feature. It's good to have, and it's important. Unfortunately, this is a unique thermocouple. So got to looking at it. I don't know if I can show you, but I'll try it. Right down in here, I got really close in here and took a good look. And this resistor is actually broken free. So I think that's really where the problem came in. Yeah, see, there's a gap there. That should be connected. So that's where my problem started. First thing I did, though, is I did try and clean it. Took some sandpaper. Just like everybody online says, I didn't know about the resistor part, obviously, at this point. But I took the sandpaper and I tried kind of scraping some off the debris and everything on here, because let's be honest, if it is dirty, it's not gonna sense the heat, and so it is not gonna get. Also, if your pilot is dirty, then it's also not going to generate a pilot light that's gonna stay on. So my problem really was that the pilot light would not stay lit. So what we've done is, obviously, I've taken it out to where the pilot, or the whole burner assembly sits in there. It sits like this. I've cleaned off the burner assembly, vacuumed it all off to get some of the extra debris off of here, because obviously just over time, this is a 10-year-old model, so over time things are going to start to have some issues. I've got it all set aside, and now this thing, worthless, what I've been able to do is locate, brand new assembly part. So just remember, if I can do it, so can you. We're now going to go ahead and I'm going to go through and we're going to unscrew the previous one. Ooh, isn't that pretty looking? Look how shiny and neat and new. Isn't that gorgeous? Wow. So we're going to undo the assembly on here, the pilot assembly. Looks like this screw here and this screw over here are the ones we're going to take off, and we're going to reinstall the new pilot assembly. Once we do that, we'll reinstall the burner assembly and try kicking it on. Now, before I did anything, obviously, this is off, okay? This is where our gas comes in. But more importantly, this is off. This is my gas in as well. So this is, even if this were to be shutting off 99.9% of gas, I still have a danger. So we've got the gas turned off here as well. That way, there's no problems. Okay, so just keep in mind, I may be a noob, but I'm not an idiot. So, first thing we're going to do is we're going to try and undo these screws, which obviously been in here for some time, so it's going to take a little bit of effort. All right, let's get that out of there. Okay. Okay. Number one, and let's get number dos. Okay. I'm pretty sure we're going to need it because I don't see screws with the assembly. And number two. Okay. All right. Now, let's try and take this thing apart. Looks like it's in here. It's got a slight catch. There we go. Look at that. Came out nice and easy, didn't it? All right. Let's get that out of the door, which we've got the old burner assembly out, which you can see here is pretty corroded and crusty. And we've got the new party neat and spiffy one there without any corrosion at all. Look at the difference there. So now I'm going to go ahead and install this again there. Same thing. Just going to come in here and we're going to put it in and get it inside that little catch there and screw it in. All right. Slide these bad boys in here without making too much of a mess. Obviously, we're working in there. Okay. All right. Now, burner assembly. Here, put this together now. Oop, put that aside and get it, make it a little easier for me. A little bit of finagling because obviously, you know, this is brand new, so it's just a little adjustment. So I had to take and actually kind of bend it a little bit in place. But we've got the screws in there, those back in their place. It looks like this is a pretty good adjustment here as far as burner assembly goes. It's about where it was the last time, so I'm not going to mess with it too much. Last thing I want to do is interfere with that burner head. So, but it looks like it's a pretty good gap, you know, but it's not huge, so it's just enough to be able to light that burner. So now I'm going to make sure and go ahead and put this the stopper in here again, or rather, the stopper I think is going to pretty much stay where it was. The door is going to fit to it. Next up, we're going to be reassembling this. So, unfortunately, I'm going to need two hands, so I have to apologize. Insert the burner assembly back to where it was. We're going to try and make sure and get that right in there where we're sitting in the past. It's kind of hard to see, but it's resting on that again. So that is going to be important. Because the last thing we want is this to go back. So that has to sit in there, and this has to be able to go right up here and get back into that hole there. So that's the goal. Tighten this down. Righty tighty. Lefty loosey. Obviously, this is a gas line, so let's not play around with this. We're going to make sure it is 100% before we actually turn the gas back on. Okay. Got this hooked up nice and tight, and obviously, we've got these two babies to hook up. Now, one is a gas line for the pilot. And the other is just a copper conductor. There's no tube in there. Okay, that actually is what goes to our thermocouple. Okay, so the smart thing would have been to take a picture of this before we get to going. So luckily I'm smart enough to have done that. So this is going to go over here. Zoop. This goes underneath. And we'll hook up into here. And we'll screw that in and tighten her down. Now this puppy over here is going to go up inside of here because it's a gas line. And ta-da. And it will eventually tighten up. So I'm going to tighten these up and then I'll be back. These bad boys hooked up and tightened down really good. So next thing we're going to do is we're going to connect this. This is our electric line for our starter. And obviously this comes all the way up here and connects up to this guy. So we'll do that right up here. See, there's our starter button. So I'm gonna go ahead and connect that real quick. Special instruction, okay, to this is we're gonna put it down, we're gonna push this down, we're gonna hit the starter 3, 4, 5 times until it starts. And we'll see that through the window in here, and we'll see that pilot go on that blue light. However, we gotta keep this button depressed all the way down for 60 seconds in order to maintain that. And like I was saying before, to make sure that we've got our thermocouple all warmed up so that it knows that it's right, it's working. So we're gonna go ahead and do it. Ready? We're gonna go ahead and come down here. We're gonna take a look, and pray to God, if it blow up, we'll know why. Got it on pilot lighting. Got the pilot ready to go. Got the gas back on. Troubleshooting here. And obviously we've got our thing. I've undone the what I believed to be the pilot. And I'm just going to test it real quick, and we'll listen. We'll hear that. And this is just a burst, so just so we know. Yeah, did you hear that? Yeah. So clearly this is the right valve. Okay, so this is going in here. This is going where it needs to be. Everything's all hooked up. I'll do a little more troubleshooting, and hopefully we'll get this bloody thing to work. All right, we're going to pull this out. All right, that right there is where our spark is. It connects to this puppy, but it's grounding somehow or another because I keep feeling a spark every now and then over here. So what I'm going to do is I'll try connecting it this way. Let's see if that will do it. And then we can put that sleeve back over. Okay. It's on, and we're gonna now see if we have this here, we click this, we're gonna spark here, and if my finger's anywhere near it, it's gonna get sparked. So now this rubber, this little orange rubber sleeve here, is supposed to cut that out. However, I can tell you right now, I've been sparked a couple times through the sleeve up top. So now we've got it over here. It's running this way instead. We got this still on. We got this ready to go. We're going to push this down. Maybe it won't connect, won't rub against here and spark out if we get it this direction here. So let's see if we can get down here into this. Hold down that, and holy crap, we got spark. Look at that, and it's staying on too. Oh my gosh, look at that. Holy cow. Isn't that amazing? We got a pilot. So, now we're going to do what it says. Turn it on. I'm following instructions here, people. And then we're going to turn it up. Look at that, baby. Oh, yeah. Woo, doggy. And so, there we go. Everything's back on and running. I'm going to go ahead and put this cover back on after I wait a few minutes, make sure this doesn't kick off again like it did before. I don't expect that it will, since that resistor is brand new and has been replaced. So obviously, if I can do it, you sure as heck can. From one idiot to another, have a nice day.